Hi, this is Tom Sedlak, General Manager at 33rd Company Property Management. Thanks so much for taking time out of your busy day to watch this podcast on HOA violations and tips for enforcing HOA rules. You know, HOAs are governed by lots of laws and lots of documentation. In particular, there are declarations, there are R&R rules and regulations, and there are bylaws, and most HOAs and common interest communities have all of these documents on file. The declarations generally are embedded into the title of the actual property so that any owner of an HOA must abide by those documents because they are embedded in that title. HOA rules are sort of like a blade of grass. At the very base, you have those declarations that are embedded in the specific title of the property, and they're inflexible. They're very difficult to change. They require a supermajority, generally, of the board members, as well as participating banks that have notes on the properties to change those embedded documents in the titles. So they're very difficult to do. It's very prohibitive in many cases to change those base governing declarations. Anything that a declaration says generally is non-changeable by the subsequent rules, which are the rules and regs and the bylaws, and those are the upper parts of the blade of grass, which are changeable and do bend a little bit or blow with the wind, as you can imagine. Essentially, the rules and regs are voted on based on the requirements of the declaration, whether there's a majority vote of the board or a majority vote of the entire constituency of the HOA. That's how you would change your HOA rules. You can't deny something that is specifically allowed in the declarations. For instance, rentals. Many times the declarations don't say that rentals are not allowed, which means that they are in fact allowed, and yet some boards will vote to disallow rentals in their rules and regs completely, and that's not actually an enforceable rule. And so you have to be very careful with making sure that the rules and regs are only amending the already allowed rules in the declaration, not changing what's allowed and what's not allowed. Same thing with the bylaws. Typically, for such rules, for R&Rs and bylaws to be enforceable, they have to be clear, they have to be articulated, and they have to be voted properly by the board or by the constituency in order for such rules to be enforceable. Fines typically are added to those rules to help put some teeth behind the typical HOA rules to make sure that people comply. In order to have a fine, they have to be stipulated, and they have to be consistently and fairly enforced across your HOA. Typically, you want to start out with a fine with a polite warning letter. You want to give people that have innocent lapses or non-compliances an opportunity to cure that issue without incurring any type of a financial impact or fine. Fines will discourage future violations once they're aware of it, if they hadn't been aware of it before, and generally you're going to gain compliance and continue to maintain the hospitable environment of your HOA and not alienate your members directly. But enforcement rules can also be escalating. One of the best tools that boards and HOA memberships can use is an escalating fine structure in their rules and regs or their bylaws. And by this I mean if you have, for instance, a pet violation where, let's say that the pet rules are 25 pounds maximum and you have someone that brings in a pet that's higher than that, you can give them the first violation, which is just a warning letter saying you have to remove your pet because it exceeds the pet size. Then the subsequent letter might have a small fine, and then a subsequent letter after that, after another week, might have a larger fine, and so on and so on. And essentially, you're escalating the rule, which allows you to impose a smaller fine for people that generally would comply if they were either aware of it or the nominal cost of that initial fine is enough to make them change their behavior. But it also has a large enough stick for those more blatant disregard, serial violators that are blatantly disregarding your HOA rules. An escalating fine structure helps put teeth for those individuals. And so an escalating fine structure is probably one of the best ways that you can implement enforcement policy with your HOA rules and have it work with all of the different varieties of violators of the HOA rules. Gradual escalation is also a good way to maintain your relationship and to prevent alienating the constituency and having problems from that regard too. So it's usually the best way to have a fine structure imposed. Fines are usually charged and paid before member dues. So with any typical rule and regulation violation or bylaw violation, there's going to be a fine that's going to be submitted on the monthly statement with the regular monthly dues of the individual member. It's typically the practice of most HOA agents to apply any incoming funds to the fine first and then subsequently apply the balance to the member dues. And when this is done, the fine is immediately paid. Any lapse in payment then becomes a delinquency of the dues payment, and then it would also trigger then additional late fees or unpaid dues fees that might be listed in the R&Rs and the bylaws. So this is always a pretty good standard practice that most HOA agents would adhere to, and it should be stipulated as well in your R&R and bylaws. And this is where a good agent can help you edit those and get some good rules and regs. How much should a fine be? There's really no way to say how much a specific fine should be. However, the general rule of thumb is a fine needs to be high enough so that people comply with it. So sometimes if you find that your fine structure is too low and you have a lot of belligerent members that aren't subscribing to the rules of the HOA, then maybe consider raising your fine level or raising it or converting it into an escalating fine structure. That way you'll know where the threshold is for gaining compliance over your members. And it really does vary from HOA to HOA. It really depends on the economic level of the individual members within that HOA. If they're willing to pay $25 a month to have a non-compliant pet in perpetuity, maybe you need to change that fine to make it $100 per month, escalating to $200 to $400 to $500 over the subsequent months of violation, so that at some point you will find that pain point and gain the compliance of that particular member. So it really is good to have that escalating fine structure, because it's very difficult to determine what a specific fine is going to be enough to deter problematic behavior. And so this would be generally our recommendation. Our company, 33rd Company, can certainly help find some of the more contemporary verbiage and fine structures that can be added to your rules and regs and bylaws. And this is why you want to really pick a good agent that's going to work with you and be an advocate for the HOA to help enforce its rules and not just simply rubber stamp what a board comes up with. Okay, in summary, a gradual escalation policy is always prudent to allow good relationships to be maintained. Don't just jump right in with an immediate fine. Most contracts do have a requirement to allow the violator a period of time to cure their deficiency. An escalating structure is always the best method, we found, to ensure that you have a large enough stick to correct the behavior of all of your members, and there's a varying degree. And then the last thing is to make sure that all of your rules are actually compliant with state statute, with local, state, federal laws, HUD, EPA. Make sure that the rules that you've instilled have been attorney reviewed, that they have been clearly articulated to the voting constituency, they've been voted properly, you've documented the proxies and the votes, and you can enforce the rules. Thanks so much for watching our video podcast. For more information on HOA and CIC rules and how to enforce them, please visit our website at 33rdcompany.com or contact one of our experienced HOA managers. Thanks for listening.